Hi, I'm Chet Haas from the Android team at Google. I work on graphics and animation stuff here, and today I wanted to talk about some animation stuff. Surprise, surprise. Specifically, I wanted to talk about view animations, which is the set of animation APIs that are available prior to the 3.0 release. So there's some more modern APIs that we'll talk about in future episodes, but for now we'll talk about the APIs that you might want to use if you're running on devices that are running platforms prior to the 3.0 release. So view animations were created specifically for animating the visual properties of views. It's not a general purpose animation engine, but a way to achieve specific visual effects for your user interface. So let's take a look at a demo, which I called view animations. We have a few buttons on the screen that are named after the animations that are going to be run when you click on them. So we have an alpha animation, a translate animation that moves the button around, rotate animation, a scale animation, and then a set animation is basically a way to choreograph several animations on the same object. So we run all of those types of animations on that one button to give a really horrible effect, which I expect to not see in any of your applications. Now, all of these animations that we're running here were created and run in code, but you can also load them from animation resources, which we'll see in the code in a minute. So we can get exactly the same types of effects loading from XML resources instead. So now let's take a look at the code. So we have this class called ViewAnimations. It's an activity. We have a checkbox that controls whether we load from resources or create these on the fly in code. We have the buttons that are created here. We have alpha, translate, rotate, scale, set, and then we listen for clicks on those buttons and run the animations appropriately. This is the interesting part about how the animations are actually created. So this is how you create some of these animations in code. So here's an alpha animation. We say we want an alpha animation that's going to go from 1 to 0. That's basically saying from fully opaque to fully transparent. And we're going to set the duration. Note that view animations don't have a default duration, so you need to set a duration to have any animation at all. Otherwise, they'll just happen atomically and immediately, which is probably not the kind of animation effect you're looking for. We have a translate animation that's going to be moving in both X and Y, and you have the ability to move in absolute coordinates or relative to self or relative to parents. You can basically say, I want to move for half of my parents' width. For example, again, we set the duration and that animation is done. Rotate animation, again, we have the concept of being relative to self, relative to parent. We have a pivot point that we're rotating around. Here, we're pivoting around the center point of the button itself, so it's just going to rotate around its center. Set the duration and we're done. Scale animation, we're going to scale in both X and Y from 1 to 2, which is saying from my normal 100% size to a 200% size. And the set animation is a way of combining all of these animations to run all on the same button to give that really horrible effect that we saw. We set up each of these animations, which is just a method that I created to say, you know, either use the animations we created above or create them from resources, which we'll see in a minute. And then we listen in on the button. When the button is clicked, then we run the animation appropriately. So that's the code side of this. The resource side we can take a look at. And it should be fairly straightforward. If you understand how to create these in code, you'll understand what the attribute names are in the XML resource. So here's the alpha animation. We say from an alpha of 1 to an alpha of 0 duration. We're going to make this a little bit faster in XML resources. Rotate. We've got 2 degrees 360, so it's basically going to spin an entire cycle, and it's going to pivot around half of its own width. So it's got a center point right in its center. For the rotation. Scale animation here, from X and Y of 1, so that's from its normal 100% size to an X and Y scale of 2, so going to 200% duration of 1,000. And here's the set. So this is how we choreograph animations and do several things either in parallel or in sequence. We're actually doing all of these all together, so they're going to happen all at the same time to give the most egregious effect possible. But you can stagger these in time as well by using a start offset. Here we have an alpha animation that's going to kick off at the same time as a rotate animation, at the same time as a scale animation, and at the same time as a translate animation. So to load these, we can go back and look at the code. And instead of just running the animation that we created in code above, we do a animation utils load animation and load it from the resource ID that we specified. So the takeaway from this today is it's fairly easy to create these things and to run these animations and get some simple effects, basically moving things around on the screen and fading them in and out, which can be a very powerful tool to help your users understand what's going on in your UI. Fade the things in that are coming into view, fade them out if they're going away, move things into position, and basically give a more immersive and intuitive experience to your users. In future episodes, we'll see alternate ways of doing this kind of stuff, as well as other more powerful animations. Thanks for tuning in.